Let's take a look at another example where we're going to use a different operator. So in this example, we want to show the name of all products that are not in the same department as products with a price less than 100. So in this case, we would take a look at all of our different prices. We would find all the ones that have a price less than 100. In this case, it's this right here. The bacon is in the department movies. So I would not want to show any other product that is also from the department movies. It looks like none of these others are from movies. So I would show all the remaining products' names. And that's the idea. So once again, we need to probably first figure out which operator we want to use. And then from there, we'll figure out the structure of data that's going to come back from our subquery. Well, in this case, the operator we're going to use is kind of prominently displayed in the goal of the query itself for this question. It says not in. So we want to take a look at the department of all of our different products and make sure that the department that we list right here that we're currently iterating over is not present in a list of departments that we're going to achieve through our subquery. So in this case, we're going to make use of not in. So we can go back to our table. So if we are making use of not in, that means that our subquery must return a single column. And as you'd probably guess here, our subquery is going to return back a single column that contains the departments that contain an item that is less, that has a price less than 100. So as usual, let's go and try to write out the subquery first. The goal of the subquery is to find a list of the departments that have a product with a price less than 100. So for that, we might write out something like select department from products where the price is less than 100. And if I run that, it looks like all these different departments right here have a product inside them that is less than $100. You'll notice that some of them are repeated, such as baby right here. That is to be expected because we're not doing any kind of condensing down logic. We're saying just look at all the different products, find all of them that have a price less than 100, and return their department. So there might be multiple different products from the same department with a price less than 100, as is the case with baby. Okay, so that's going to be our single column of data. So we would put that in right here as our subquery. So select department from products where price is less than 100. That's going to give us back the single column. So now we're going to take a look at each individual department from our products table and make sure that each individual products department is not present in that list right there. Now we can merge the result of these two queries together. I'm going to start off from scratch. I'll put in select name. And even though the question didn't really ask for it, I'm going to print out the department as well. And then we're going to get all of our different rows from products where the department is not in a list that we're going to produce right here. So our list of records is going to be the department from products where the price is less than 100. I'm then going to take a quick glance before we read this, or before we run it. I'm just going to make sure that in the results of this query, I don't see any departments like movies, tools, outdoors, industrials, electronics. I'm going to run that. I shouldn't see anything like movies, tools, industrials, electronics. And I definitely don't see any here. So I'd say that this is probably working as expected. Okay, so that's another example of a subquery. And again, we have made sure, based upon the operator that we were using, that the subquery was returning the correct structure of data. All right, let's take another pause, and then we're going to move on to the right side of the table over here and take a look at some other operators.